Number one is my baby party. Once upon a time, there were three dumb bunnies who lived in a log cabin made out of bricks. Mama bunny was really dumb. Papa bunny was even dumber. And baby bunny was the dumbest bunny of all. One day, the dumb bunnies were eating their porridge. Mama bunny's porridge was too cold, so she blew it on it. Papa bunny's porridge was too hot, so he put it in his oven. But baby bunny's porridge was just right, so he poured it down his pants. "That's my boy," said Papa bunny. The baby bunnies decided to go to town and finish their porridge later. "Should we drive or should we take our bikes?" asked Papa Bunny. "Let's take our bikes," said Mama Bunny. "We could use the exercise." So they took their bikes. "Can I drive the car?" asked Baby Bunny. "You don't know how to drive," said Papa Bunny. "You get us all killed." "Oh, please," said Baby Bunny. "No, okay," said Papa Bunny. "Wee!" cried Baby Bunny. "That's my boy," said Papa Bunny. When the dumb bunnies finally got to get to town, they had a marvelous time. They went ice skating at the lake. They bought a home run at the public library. And they had a nice picnic lunch at the car wash. Meanwhile, back at the dumb bunny's house, a little girl came speaking up the sidewalk. The little girl had a very white skin. Her skin was as white as snow. In fact, her skin was so snowy white that everybody called her Little Red Goldilocks. Oh, true, nobody was quite sure why. Little Red Goldilocks broke into the dumb bunny's house and made herself right at home. When the dumb bunnies returned, they knew something was not right. "Somebody been sleeping in my porridge," said Papa Bunny. "Somebody been eating my bed," said Mama Bunny. "And somebody been using my paperclip," cried Baby Bunny. Suddenly, the dumb bunny saw the inspector. "My name is Little Red Goldilocks," she said. "I have beautiful golden locks." "Now, yeah," said Papa Bunny. "And you have nice yellow hair, too." The dumb bunnies love Little Red Goldilocks. Papa Bunny loved her so much, he danced a merry dance. Mama Bunny loved her so much, she sang a merry song. And Baby Bunny loved her so much, he flushed down the merry toilet. "That's my boy," said Papa Bunny. Finally, the dumb bunnies returned to their porridge, which by noon was just right temperature. So they poured it on their head and lived happily ever after. The end.